So, SKDL Sir Spud.
Why would he play with Kari when he's on the loser's side? Dale was wondering why he wasn't playing with Kari. Like, he's on the loser's side.
No, and I'm trying to think too. How is the scissor matchup versus Chomp?
I think Chomp wins this. I think Chomp wins that matchup.
Oh.
The problem is that his charge takes too long. His, or not charge, his. Counter. Wow, the words are not coming to mind. Scizor's counter is too slow. That's one of the problems. And he has to approach his last turn. It is. He also has to approach way more than his characters. Gengar doesn't have to approach as much.
Good eye there for sure, but
he only approaches when he knows. Figuring where the astonishes. That was my downfall. Dale here is actually pretty good at knowing when they're coming and knowing when to punish them.
Yeah. Committing to that counterattack actually doing enough damage here. The curses might have just gotten down to that level.
The curses did, and he's really close to first, so that's why he was doing it. Oh, goodness.
Did you cover it with a vulnerable break? Mistake,
yeah. A little much when you think about it, though. I wouldn't mess up doing that much. Especially if a power character has a lot of health. That's why I like it if power characters have less health. Where you mess up once, you take a lot of health, and you get a lot of debuffs. Like, she makes one mistake to the dogs. Will hit, and it's not going to it might.
Good iron from SKDL there, though. Trying to beat the That'll let him, but not going to be able to get that much needed burst
thing. Yeah, that burst thing. Well, Dale's really good at having giving you a challenge for a ground-based burst attack. Like what Mewtwo does. The only problem is that the only thing is that Gengar has more range, so yes, he still has to pick you back. But Dale's really good at his air beam, so he'll help a lot on that anyway. Put them real over.
Ooh, nice high frames.
Alright. Tries to go. Alright. As far as you can go for the shadow.
Alright, SKDL will take game one here.
My problem about that shadow ball, the shadow ball mix-ups is the charging is so specific on what it is. And it's like, it's really hard to figure out. Especially if you're not a Gengar player. None of us are, besides Spud. So none of us really have the timing down of if it's going to be a grab, unless you guys do it on the slow.
I don't know how to fight this guy, so I'm not going to try to make it sound like I know how to fight.
I mean, a lot. Still getting everything. Yep, you gotta dash away from those things. Those things have really good tracking power.
Really good pressure there from SKDL because the jump release, or what they call the hyper, anti-projectile. So he did that against the charged shadow ball. Now, I think Sir Spud could have counterattacked it if he knew what was going to happen. But would have taken out Pelican. Really good exchanges here.
I like it!
Holy cow.
I like it.
Alright. I'll do that.
There's a go for a grab. He doesn't realize he's already in iframes. There's gonna be overhang.
What's truly impressive is this guy just came back from the command range. We know he's tired, and he's sitting there in grand finals. Playing really well, right?
It's pretty close. On both ends.
I think when he went quiet for 2 days, he went to Japanese training.
He did. He went to Japanese training, though. He was still playing Pokemon.
It's the only logical thing.
He was still playing Pokemon. It doesn't matter.
Honestly, he's doing very well for
him. He's doing very well.
Spud's got a great advantage in this round now. Field. Good whiff punish there from Sir Spud, taking a quick game too.
Yep. Discussing something separate. I don't know. Could go either way.
It could. Sir Spud's really good at adapting, I think, so he's probably changing his strategy here.
You know, the fact that he hasn't played Bale in at least 2 weeks because he's been playing.
I mean,
after all nighter also.
They fought earlier in bracket.
They
did.
2-0 him. Yeah, and that's why I was saying it has been a while since these two have played.
Yeah.
I think since the last monthly, so. Ooh, oh my gosh, 6x, alright. I think 6x is worse than Dale. I think Dale can agree with me on that.
6x is at least as punishable as Dale. It's easily beatable.
You have to use it. You have to use it as a meaty.
Really good perfect there.
It was a perfect, yeah. Didn't realize that wasn't perfect. The torpedo hitting him right as he's letting down his
I'm sure he tried to work his pocket. One of the things that he was talking about earlier was that Lugar's field pitch is entirely single hit. Aside from my charge K1.
What is single hit?
Everything that Lugar does. So, you have a perfect block, nearly everything that Lugar does.
Yeah. I think jump wise, well, forward wise, I meant to say forward wise. Forward wise is punishable as it is. All four, pretty much all four. Yours, only yours isn't.
Mine is punishable for the CLC.
I mean, on shield.
Yeah, block. Exactly.
Most forward wise are.
Hypnosis. Alright, Sir Spud.
I like how hypnosis in first isn't even hypnosis. It's just. It's literally just reset the move. It's just a reset. It's not a move, it's a reset. Okay, in game four. Sir Spud, of course, in the loser bracket, so the loser side, so if he wins one more, he will reset and put SK Dale in the losers.
It's always an opportunity, though.
Yep. Dale can certainly do it. I think Spud is probably just adapting a little bit more.
He's gonna switch up his style here. But...
Oh, yeah. Yeah. But he has shown it does work out.
That's
exactly. That clear on counter, and it always goes for that curse. It's like the most optimal thing he has, like ever.
Might as well, it generates a lot of synergy. It
generates synergy, you only lose about 30 health. And then you get like 10 CC. So, why not? Nice timing on that punish on that NX.
Ooh, not the nothing.
Why? Why does that do that?
It's so many baby fingers.
It's a little too high.
A little too high,
even for, well, I shouldn't be saying homing attack because I have that privilege in normal, as normal Mewtwo, so. Ooh, nice shield there by SK Dale, getting the really sucks. Not doing as much damage though.
That's fine, he honestly called that out, really, really sucks.
It was a good one, yeah. Maybe he knew he wasn't going to do as much damage. Yeah, I've never seen release that speed on the challenge. Don't challenge that. That's very hard to challenge.
You can challenge it. It just depends on distance. Like, the simple I can line up spear check one.
Yeah.
I think it'll disrupt the projectile and then also hit him. Also hit him.
Yeah, I can't do that. It's just With the characters that have projectiles that take time to get the opponent, like Mewtwo, you just have to shield him. Because there's not really much. He doesn't really have an anti-projectile in the field. I mean, you could maybe barrier it if you have a big Mewtwo in the timing. That's still the way to do it. Gengar could disappear if it was this time.
That might snag him. And it will. Okay.
Alright.
Good eye there.
Tie him up in rounds here.
That's like the only... I think there's only like one of them. And that's of course one of them. Yes. Sits up in the air for the
jump 2X?
That's
jump 2X. Jump 2X is when he does that. Ooh, tries to go for the 6-5. Yeah, Sir Spud. It is hard to get rid of those projectiles. It's hard to get rid of those slugs. Because not even... There aren't that many moves that get rid of those slugs. You kind of just have to take them. And as I said earlier, you really shouldn't care about this move. Yeah, you're going to get attacked. It's going to last a little bit, but don't let it... You should never let it keep you from doing combos.
Right. There's a high chance.
I have seen people drop that. Shadow Ball.
Yeah, it worked out quite well.
Yeah. As I was saying, the Sludge Pools, I've seen people drop combos because they were scared of the Sludge Pools. Don't worry about it. It's going to go away.
Yeah. So Sir Spud is going to get the reset here.
Yep. Challenger.
Good time.
Very good time. What do you want to do for your cheer skills?
Because Sir Spud was on the loser side, and SKDL hasn't lost a set yet. It's technically, SKDL was still on the winner side.
Yes.
And he hasn't lost a set. Basically, we're resetting because Spud won on the loser side, but I still have another set. Because you always have to lose twice.
Into the reset here.
Basically, Dale's now on the loser side.
These two sticking to their normal plans.
I think he had a different support. I think he switched to Mew. Oh, no, he didn't.
They're using the same support.
I don't know why they're switching. They may have. Oh, they're probably the same support.
Yeah.
Good on them. Even though I don't feel like...
Surprisingly enough, that SKDL committed to the Earthquake.
Yeah. If I were to give one good piece of advice to get against Gengar, unless you're really gonna hit it, don't go for that last. Don't go for that last one. Shield, especially against Spud. Spud is really good at that. On the shield, he just knows it. Gengar has a lot of. Can I just say that we're not even 60 seconds into this match and maybe get rid of it? I think he got the
axe. No, he definitely got it. No other way.
Evil laugh. But it was just all a fluke. Last games were just a last set. Was just a fluke. And they played off. You'll be seeing that later when our evolve kit uploaded. Whenever they get. I think it's been 3 months.
No, I caught it.
Oh, you did? Okay.
Sometimes I think I'm on like April 27th.
Nice unreal.
He was able to sneak away from it a bit, but
it got rid of the projectile. Other projectiles. I think Umbreon gets rid of the slug pools, so. Nice grab there by Spud. Get rid of the Shadow Ball. Ooh! This KDL quickly shooting.
Yeah. He's trying to get those perfect blocks off.
That's where SKDL gets me. Like, I'm so scared of those Shadow Balls. I have to avoid them. Why isn't the cheese stick getting
Butter too?
Butter stick? I call it the cheese stick because you're ripping into it. And you get it from the top down. You're like a bad person.
All of that damage, too many Christmas. That two Well, you have rage. And then the post game is one confirmed got killed. No, finish it.
Off. Stupid. That was nuts. I'm gonna bring this closer because I feel like I'm not that good fire. I'm a little too fire right now. I don't know. I'll tell you what. Anyway. Shadow Ball.
Pressure on.
Ooh, overhand. Into the 6-Y. Or 5X. It was 5X. No, it was 4X. It was 4X. Shield, bro. Oh, it's so hard to counter that.
Make a good grab.
Oh my gosh. It's such bad timing. Oh my gosh. This damage. Oh.
Catch him, he caught him.
That was a good, that was good.
Except I'm not gonna kill him.
Rage. Oh my gosh.
Immediately put into the health lead.
I'm gonna Gale's cheese stick. I was gonna say Gale's cheese stick. It's about full. Butter stick, cheese stick. They're both made from cows. I think. Yeah, butter's made from cows. From cow's milk. No. Here's the thing. You don't need to kill a cow to make cheese and butter. So there you go. It's all from milk, which is naturally made. So yeah. So they're both almost the same.
So Pokemon.
Pokemon. Hey, Miltank is in Pokemon, and Pokemon are in Pokemon. Cheese curds.
Good, alright.
That's all we got.
Yep. Try to go for the last game, but unfortunately, it's not working out there anymore.
Nice combo there by Sir Spud. That's such a bad combo. I feel bad for anyone trying to learn Gengar. Dig is almost good. Almost.
It's that hitboxing. I honestly don't know why it's not.
I think it's because they thought it would be too good. And then again, why would you make it?
Like, the hitboxing is already a punishable move. You want to make it a little frustration for the player.
I don't think they meant it to be a...
Oh my god.
I don't think they meant it to be like a law move, though. Because all the combos that they do, all the combos that Pokken shows with Gengar, a lot of combos that they show with Garchomp involve Dig hitting after having it confirmed in the summer house. Nice grab there. Into the kill.
The pretty interesting setups, I think, here from Sir Spud, to go down option and just set it up to where he can punish because Dale's going to run up. Run in there, get that grab.
I'm proud of him. I'm proud of him. That's what you do in this game. You just run up. First thing you do is just run up and grab. And he's back. Now he switched it up.
Sir Spud got it.
Yeah, I know. He switched it up.
Scary spot for him to be in, I guess.
So here comes the problem. Dale got hit by all three of those.
Last a while.
I think it's like 10 seconds.
I think it adds up.
You need a pressing character to play against. There's just a lot of small tears that just kind of just adds up the pen to anger.
Oh my god. Okay. Try to cover a vulnerable frame that did not work out. But taking game two here.
Yep. I mean, I can understand Dale getting a little like.
Yeah. It's frustrating. For
it's
sure,
frustrating.
If you let
Gengar itself, it's frustrating.
Yeah. But I mean, and a lot of players fall to this. You let the control of your match. You got to take second three.
That's why you. Yeah. Like, it's way harder to perform well if you start letting things get to you. And it only works out. The only time it ever works out is if it's just like. Nice tornado there. One that confirmed quite a bit. Whoa! A lot of cross-ups here. A lot of break is kind of broken in this game. It's a little too good. Alright. Oh, getting hit by the Astonish there. Oh, I got tipped by it. And it's so easy to forget that thing really has a
push him to the corner.
Whoa.
Get some damage off.
Very scary.
Ooh.
I thought that was two release X's in one combo.
Nice grab. Not taking it just yet.
That's an 11 frame, right?
Yep. Oh, even though the EV recovering some health, able to get the Dragon Claw and punish the fall.
The Dragon Claw is powerful.
Got him in the air.
Tipped him. Oh, misses the jump.
Dying.
The curse.
He hasn't been doing the grab
Shadow Ball.
I'd honestly, he didn't pull that off against me once. Like, you were the only person I saw him pull off.
Maybe he because he knows that you two aren't getting punished by it a lot. It's hard for me to figure that out.
We figured he wasn't doing anything against me because Blaziken actually has a second round.
That too.
Okay.
Dig is good.
It's working out.
It doesn't matter how many times it fails, if it works once, Dig will be good.
Yeah.
Match point for Sir Spud here. Yeah.
Ready to hang out with the Nuggets with Punnett.
The Nugget's not worth it if your opponent already has Burst. Honestly, if your opponent already has Burst, you really shouldn't go for the Nugget.
Well, I mean, he was trying to get his. He just used it and unfortunately lost all of it.
I'd rather focus on just winning the fail. That's just me.
Technically, if you get the Nugget in the face.
Exactly. Bleh. 10 CC versus 40.
That's gonna bust the shield in.
That's gonna hurt. Drops it.
Now there's. I mean, it was against a low wall stick.
Yeah.
Not a whole lot. Jump down there.
I like that Umbreon call by Dale. Oh, he almost had him in the corner. So he's probably ended up passing him up and passing him up.
Oh, the Shadow Blast opportunity here.
Yep.
Figure out something.
Nice jump, and he gets caught by the jump block.
Alright, Sir Spud dominating the reset here with a 3-0. Really good play, able to turn that around from an earlier match.
That's... game loss! Game loss. 1-3.